We're here with Drew Kerr, Dr. Suzanne Gilberg-Lenz, our resident doctor. Now, my bestie, Rossi Ross Matthews, is here. Hi, Rossi.
Hi, everybody. We are learning a lot today, Drew. So we're all learning a ton, and I know our audience members have some questions. So I'm here with James. Hi, James.
Oh,
hi, representing the men in the audience today.
Hi, James.
How are you?
Are you learning a lot today?
I am, so much.
Okay, good. And I know you probably have some questions, right?
Yes,
okay,
I do.
Hit it.
Hi, how are you? So I'm wondering, I notice a lot of women, they like going all natural down there. But others like going totally bald.
I also see there was like in the 90s, it was all about the Brazilian, which I'm still a little confused about what that is. There was also the landing strip.
I was just thinking the same thing.
Right? Yeah.
Because I have seen it all.
Okay. Just really quickly. Have you ever revealed a grooming that really surprised you?
I have one patient who likes to surprise me. She'll put surprises there for me. Yeah. She's actually a clown. Literally a clown. Anyways, that's it. Yeah, it's wild.
I like this person.
Oh, she's amazing.
Sounds like my cup of tea. Your question.
All right,
James, you ever been surprised by a clown?
No.
Just checking.
Welcome to my world, James.
Yeah. So from a medical perspective, is there a preference or is it just personal choice?
I mean, it's personal choice, but I will say, medically speaking, we grow hair as adults for a reason. And, you know, there are protective benefits for having hair. Mm-hmm. There's literally a barrier. You know, listen, do you just be safe out there and I don't know, appreciate all the wide variety.
All right.
Thank you. I've learned something.
Good.
Thank you for that question. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. These conversations are informative and hilarious, James. Thank you. Our next question is, hi. Lexi, right?
Yes, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. What's your question?
Okay, hello.
Hi, Lexi.
Hello. I'm a professional dancer, and so I sweat a lot. How do I keep it fresh down there after a day's work?
So here's the thing. You really need to make sure that you are giving love and air and breathing room, right? So if you can change out of your sweaty garb as quickly as possible, let things air out, sleep in the nude. I like to tell people you don't need to wear underwear. It traps the heat, the bacteria, and can encourage irritation and actually infections. I also really want to point out that keeping yourself clean and hygienic does not involve using harsh chemicals, wipes, or products outside or inside. I mean, if you want to, you know, get some soap on the vulva on the outside because you're a little bit dirty, fine, but nothing should ever be going inside. Your body is perfect. Your body is a self-cleaning oven in that part of your body. And we don't want to strip away those normal occurring oils, bacteria that are protecting us.
Can I also add a question, which is, do you change quickly out of your wet clothing?
It really depends on the day, but let's say I have rehearsal from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. I'm in those clothes the whole time.
Yeah. What is something she can do in that case? Because some people don't have the luxury. Could you bring a change of underwear?
Yeah, or you could change, if you have time to do a change of clothing, that's okay too.